You don't need a win here, you need to build a great company. Guys, I will just go and kick them now.
Okay!
Let me kick them. Let me kick those guys like with the face or something. Can you come? Thank you. Everyone, please have a seat and shut up. Up here. Just take security, you know. So be nice now. I'm a nice guy. But if Donald Trump would be here, you know, this would go crazy. You know? So first thing, but here, who is the winner of the audience? So you think I am? Okay. 11 teams is. All teams ready?
Yeah!
Great. So, please, again, huge part of our event is also one thing. Anything very good. We have jury today. So, it's not so important actually, but we have some of them. So, first, I'm very proud. I am proud of the jury, but I am so important. I think that the most important guy is Indra. Please stand up. Woo! Because he has really been here also 48 hours with you, has followed a lot, and he has experienced how hardware startups or this kind of startups should really like being successful. Because my experience is in like just you know Crash 48 and Python. I mean, Python is not a hardware startup. So we have Rannam, please stand up. Then we have Victor here from Microsoft. Woo! So that's the jury, you know. But we have super hard choice to make because as I said, you know, like it's so hard to see what will happen in the future. So this moment we'll focus what have you done, how good is the team. What have you developed in this 48 hours? Basically, one who's able to audience can just go to the special special photo album and just like the team photo of what you see. And after that, we have time and we will choose teams randomly, as we do always. So basically, where is the papers? Here. So I will actually already announce the first team which should move here, because you will start to prepare now. The first team which will move here is... It can't be better. It can't be, because we will start with... Paul! Make your setup. And what I want to tell you is that Nova will announce the second team, and as soon this team has done the presentation, because as you can see, those things they move all the way. That's why you have to be fast, and we want to show these things very fast. Next day, we should already start to prepare and be ready for the thing. It's a snoop! Woo! So, you prepare the second thing. So, but good news is that we are now most likely close to ready. And first time in the last 4 days, all the community is excited. All the guys who don't have girlfriend, and majority of the engineers don't have girlfriend, isn't it?
No, porn is such not a simple thing.
So, you want to start now? Are you ready? Do we have timer?
One moment.
Some guys are not ready to finish, but obviously girls are not ready to start, but for now we are preparing. It will take a few seconds.
So just you can tell us, did you have any challenges over the weekend? What was the biggest challenge? Share your experience before. I'll assume you're ready, but first, what was the experience of the challenges that you had over the weekend?
Thanks for this opportunity. Obviously, to create something new is really exciting. If you know, virtual reality is a blooming trend. It is on TechCrunch. So we will completely new. To be honest, it is more interesting that to develop something that in the market. For example, do you know Pornhub? Who uses Pornhub? Just raise your hand. Just process. So, if you know, the porn business is a regular business. For example, 30% of internet users enjoy porn. And interesting facts are dedicated to the porn. It is $30 billion annually industry, $30 billion, almost the Ukraine budget. And huge changes is coming. Virtual reality is on the verge of the porn industry. It will be new industry with at least $1 billion virtual reality porn segment. So we decide to be one of the first teams who are creating gadgets and software in this field. And today we will show new era of masturbation. We will show not such kind of gadgets that you could buy for $500, and even not such kind of vibrators that cost $100, not a handmade like this one. We wanna test handmade gadget. Would you like? No? I will do it myself. Tasting. Okay, we want to present something completely new. Toys, sexual toys their activity synchronously to the porn video that user sees in his porn device. Virtual reality one first person experience just now. We will do everything ourselves, and we need to show how it works. We need a volunteer. Who is going to be a volunteer? Who's going to be a volunteer? If not, I'll be a volunteer. Yeah? Some guy here? Yeah? Please come here. Please start our action. Please start. What's happening now? The Microsoft brand. Physical activity. And in application, we will know what he feels. This device that works some work that synchronously in his eyes. This device, please take it and go away and go away and to give another person to feel it. It is for the experience for 2 hours. They can watch the same. You should promise. It is an innovation. Innovation should be pushed, not pulled.
Yeah, take it.
It is a gadget for lovers. Do you love somebody? No, you don't want it. We have some girls who are believing in innovation, and 2 hours split it into they can work them to get the same activity. Okay, friends, do we have time to talk about business part? No. But you understand the business part is huge. Of masturbation will not satisfy everybody, but brings $1 billion to the companies who develop business in it.
So, thank you. Let's have a big round. What is this, by the way?
Third grade. It's like what?
Blue, heart rate. So, as we know, when somebody feels deep feeling, his heart rate is raising. As limited in time, he was not satisfied completely. It needs at least a few minutes, but our demo was less than 1.
Do we have questions? Did we have time for this one or 2 questions? Next team already should run here to set up the things, but do we have questions? You should have. You know the thing. You're the guy at sports.
So, which one would be the first market you're going to take?
Afghanistan.
If we're talking about market, yes? And when we are going to sell our devices? As we know from one report, Europe is royal legislation is not prohibited to sell things like that. We believe that our first market can be Germany and its center Berlin. It is a really innovative city. And in this city, I think there are lots of people who would like to try this device.
Okay. Do we have more questions?
A little bit different from what you're presenting now. A little bit. I think it was just for one side of the user, and now it's two parties. Yeah. Why did you change? Was there a challenge in that?
It can be done three ways. First way, one person, probably a man, we are going to focus on this market, firstly. Get a virtual reality device, get our device, and have his own personal experience. Because our artificial intelligence analyze these ones and provide personal stream of content. The second part, it was based on a question on our first presentation. The girl asked, why not to connect two lovers who are splitted and they would like to feel each other? Why not? We found that kind of this device is exist on market, and we think that two partners and became like internet of partners, internet of love between them. And the third part is education.
Why this Microsoft, is it created? What's the part of the Microsoft this hand?
It is banned. It is completely banned with sensors. We use it to collect data.
So you can't use without Microsoft hand?
We can connect it to any device a person has.
Okay. And lastly, what is your prediction and feeling? When actually can we the prototype ready that you can start to produce that and when you can be market? What's the time frame approximately?
As I understand, market will grow. We just think it should be done as soon as possible. I think in a few months we should have a prototype. If no, then we are not in the market. And we will do our best to make a prototype in 3 months.
Okay, after 3 months we can see it. Thank you!
Thank you.
Yeah. This skip of the stuff is just take this just me. Yeah. Next team is already setting up the thing. The school, are you here?
Snoop.
So come on, you should be ready now, and the next team which will start of one is a fraction. So please guys, move already here because you will be next one as soon. They are ready for questions, you should start to set up the things. But now we see some real robot action on the stage because Snoop innovate. As far as I know, warehouse business, which is pretty much still living in sometimes in the stone age, but these guys will help to make this business more effective using the robots, or three of them at least. So, and in overall, this is second team. We have after that 9 more. Go!
Hi everyone! It's time to get serious. So we are the Snoop. We are introducing a fully autonomous warehouse robot. So Amazon has broken robotic eyes 5 years ago by buying Kiva Systems in 2011, and they deployed 1,300 robots. And within 5 years, they've grown to 30,000 robot unit deployments. This is huge. And there has been a lot of companies that started up and started building robotic solutions, and they've done some really amazing progress. But when you try to excel at making robotic appliances, you want to make them complex and make them be to the point. What our team has decided to do, we tried to make simple yet elegant magic robots that match with its functionality that isn't as expensive as the real robots that are currently on the market. So we have Within these 48 hours, we have done some amazing progress. We have built a team of 7 people which are hiding over there. We have done artificial intelligence. We made a robot actually go over the obstacle course and intelligently plan its moves using unreliable components. The guys have actually got to embed a full-fledged 60,000 NDDs training set on the $35 device. So we have a running neural network there. One of the things that the guys did, they made use of a concurrent neural network from Google, so we actually have the full power of Google's image classification network in our device online. Another thing is, our team has built is, we have managed to figure out how to plan movements so we can specially recognize the position of the object in the space so we can properly tune the robot hand to grab it. Yeah. So, all of this is of course happening while all of the devices are fully connected. Of course, we would like to see you some more of the demo, but the Wi-Fi is pretty crowded, so we're not going to see some live action of video recognition. But we are getting ready to finish our prototype and approach clients. They have fully growing warehouse operations in FCGM and e-commerce. One of the things that we want to do is we want to get them not concentrate on warehouse operations and not have redesigning the warehouses from scratch. So we're going to break the ground and build better robots. Thank you very much.
Great. So next team is already preparing to set things up, but first we have time for questions. Yes.
All right.
So we have first question from here.
Okay, so as I understand, you're making, you're going to replace people in the warehouse, right?
Well, it's not just us, right? We're doing the trend of replacing human workers in warehouses, especially this is very important at scale. For example, when you're a big company like Amazon, you try to make all the operation uniform. They have more than 100 warehouses deployed, and they have each of them has a uniform size of 100k square meters. And this means, as the company is growing, they want to make their operations uniform, and we're going to help them.
Okay, so again, as I understand, you're going to replace humans in some areas like warehouse. It's very ambitious. So when you plan to actually put it on the market? Because people have been trying to do it for decades so far, and
recent 5 years, right? There are a bunch of companies that have already done that, and they've been trying to combine this and that. So we're estimating based on how well we go and how we will partner with mechanical engineering companies, because right now our world scan, as you can see it here, and when we actually they are ready to do that, we're gonna put it in there. So basically, we need to make the same thing bigger, and we probably estimate it's going to take 3 to 4 months to iron out the prototype so we can actually show it to customers and do the real job.
Okay.
Thank you.
Other?
So let's see, do we have more questions? No. What did you have if you came up here? And what you have now, what was the biggest achievement and what was changing over the weekend with your vision and the product and so on?
Well, 49 hours ago, we were not expecting to get a team at all. And we actually jumped from 2 to 4 to 5 to 7 people, which is pretty outstanding, guys. You should just come out and just like see how big the team is, and they're crazy about robots. This is pretty huge. Yeah.
Let's make a big hand for them. Woo!
So against the exercise, and thank you for you. Another thing is that we have such diverse minds in here. We had been able to explore things we didn't think we were going to touch, like robot head adjustment, like we actually can position the object in space and calculate the trajectory to it without even using any additional sensors than just the camera, which is pretty cool. Well, I guess people who know enough high school math can probably do it as well, but we actually built it. So this is pretty exciting. Yeah, so basically two of the things that are very most of the things.
Okay, great, thank you! Woo! Thank you! So next day, Proctor with the rock on here, we cut up and second. I will give you a microphone. And after this, the team which run make innovation and transportation, you are the next stop. But you are ready? Yes. Come on, guys. How many times I have to repeat? If you are next one, you have to be ready already here in the moment when we start questions. So don't just be. So one more time, I will repeat that, you know, please be active on Twitter, use GarageBand8 hashtag. Please use English because our community in worldwide speaks that language much better than you know Russian. And also, like, if you see some good things and you wanna vote for a favorite, please go to our Facebook page. We have special photo album where basically you should go and find a photo about that team and just like, and that will be your vote about that competition. But it seems that those guys are almost ready, or not yet. They're ready? Not yet. So guys, that's why you have to move here fast. Now, because now we are waiting for this guy which was slow and didn't most likely listen to me. So next team, condition guys, you have to move to the right. As soon as we start questions, we have to start to set up the things. Because we want to be sure that we can move this much faster speed. We will keep you like to add the things because we can't wait too long. So, that's the beauty of the live demos because all of the things can happen. You know, like some things can break, some things to fix. Like, right? All of the things what you see is like not recorded, but just live, happening right now. If everything, you see something is broken, then that's the way it is, that's a part of it. So now, is ready?
Is it ready?
Okay. Go.
Okay. Hello everyone, my name is Nico Juice. So today, creating smart things is pretty complex and time consuming. The IoT innovation has to come a long road till it reaches us. It moves through all steps from manufacturing the chips to all the way to the end user. It takes really a long time, and the end user usually has to choose either between a limited out of the box solution, a lot of and it's pretty sad. So here is a microcontroller, and that so all I want to do is to make it work. I want to turn on and off the LED. So do I need to have a team of professionals? Do I need to do some? I don't want to do that. I want it to be simple, as simple as turning on the light. So how can Fractal do that? In Fractal, you do basically the same thing that you do on the hardware level. You take two elements and connect them together. And after pressing the button, it works. So, how about reprogramming? The reprogramming of this of such simple model is as simple as dragging a link between the elements differently, and the logic will change. And the elements are the same, the components are the same, but the logic is different. So later on, we'll show you how this works, and we should also say that we can build more complex stuff knowing such simple processes, and we've helped other teams here, Garage 48, yet to build their solutions, and we will show you more complex schemas, like how they are built and how they work. So one of the projects is Megabot. Yeah. So we have discovered that partnerships work well for our team. And this is the way we want to build our business model. So we want to partner with manufacturers, and we want to partner with distributors and with the distributors, so that...
That's it? Thank you! Woo! So, time for... So, what do you really do? Can you... You missed the... Yes, can you do it now?
Yes.
So do it. And can you explain what happened on the screen?
Yeah, so we have a switch on the left and the LED on the right, and we have connected them together. When the switch is on, the LED will turn on as well, and vice versa. So, as you see, the linking the elements is as simple as a dragging. And so we will switch to the camera view. Okay, we're having some technical troubles, sorry.
Okay. So, okay, now we have time for questions, and transportation guy is moving next to the stage. So, what happened on the stage, or explain, maybe?
No last questions. So, who you want to have as the main user?
Thanks, that's a great question. We're targeting for the software for the integrators to use our product and pay for the licenses to us. And we also think that our product Fractal is very good in actually every fields of business, but it would be also good in education and for experimentators, for makers, for people who just want to build stuff quickly and easily, who need to build a quick prototype or something.
Okay. Do we have, yes, one more question, Bea?
As I understood, you connect the hardware part.
Yep.
Do you have some kind of connectivity to mobile or cloud in this field?
Well, it's planned.
Okay, so that would be very nice if you can design, generate simple mobile outputs connectivity to the platform.
Yeah, on the technical side, we are building a modular structure so that we can connect pretty much everything.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, cool.
Okay, great. Do we have more questions?
Yes. So am I right that the idea is that somebody can build a prototype without writing a single line of code?
Yes, you're right.
And again, your targeting audience is cheap manufacturers can you please repeat it?
Yeah. We want to partner with the hardware manufacturers so that they provide modules like for our visual builder. And we want the software of the integrators to use our solution to build
okay,
the customized solutions to the client.
Okay.
planning to make it open source so that people can use it for free for non for profit.
Okay, thank you! So, transportation guys, already setting up, here's the microphone, and I will choose the team which will be on the stage. After we have seen how this one make impact and innovation in Ukraine transportation system, the team which will be here after the next one is Megabot. So you will be here next. You should already move to the left or from the right to the stage because you will be here. And you ready?
Yes.
Go.
Okay. Hello guys, my name is Mitro and I'm glad to present the result of the hard work of my team iTrans here. Using all the same structure and technology level as 20 years ago. For example, if you want to plan your roles and operations, you just use some imagination or maybe intuition or maybe even some complex math. Imagine the simple picture where a crowd of poor passengers trying to get into the transport. They don't have any transport because the transportation company has bad planning. So today we want to open eyes of our public transports and present them the solutions that we call iTransport. This solution is based on dashboards that can automatically collect the data of passenger flows and then use it as a data for prediction and analytics. We just put some sensors and devices on vehicles, collect the data, aggregate it according to the business needs, and then get the prediction and plan. And you don't need to make any assumptions anymore if you're using our platform. You just go do it and get all valuable data that you need. We're gonna sell it like a service where you can pay as much as data you need to be calculated. So if you're a small business, there is no need to worry because you will pay less. We also offer consulting that based on the linear program stuff. So we can keep a huge amount of data, then after processing it, and make the better solution for matching the proposals and demands for your business, which is make everyone happy, passengers and product owners. Now we have a team of four mates, but after this hackathon, we continue to develop this product before it became brilliant, because we believe that we can revolutionize this industry.
Thank you. Okay, time for questions. So my first question is, what's your market? You want only to do this in Ukraine, or you see also potential to go to other markets? And which market?
We have a huge potential in Russia and Kazakhstan because they have some problems that we have here. So nobody counts the passengers accurately, so they have bad planning.
Can you use this not also some other use cases, not only this public transportation?
Yes, we can use it because we have a black box approach in forecasting. We just create some machines that can feed the data to the different models, for example, 30 of them, and then get the best prediction.
Okay. Do we have more questions from audience, from jury about this item? You have?
So I believe there should be the solutions like you do. What are your competitors here?
We have a competitors in Western Europe, but they mainly based on the transaction data about ticketing. So we don't offer this solution because we have some problems with corruption in Ukraine, and public transporters don't want to their data to be open. So we keep all their data as a secret, and we use a different approach in forecasting. It's much more accurate. And also we provide not just a forecast of passenger flows, but we provide the number of vehicles and the number of drivers that you need to operate.
So technically speaking, how do you count number of passengers in the vehicle?
During the hackathon, we start to maintain some stuff like a Raspberry Pi with sensors, but then we taking suggestion to focus on our purpose. Our purpose is service. There is no reason to think about how we can count it, because there is a lot of technologies, like, you know, the light sensors, the camera with some neural network algorithm, etc. So I believe that we can make this data 95% pure. So, yes.
Okay. Thank you for this team. So then, the next team, Megabot, is already like setting up the things because you're late. Come on. Megabot is here, and after this team, we will see the team. Its name is.
Okay, we need a book to show construction. Wait a half minute.
Yeah, but the next team is Scrolly. So you will be here after that one. Please already come to here. You don't make last minute changes. No.
No,
guys. Come on. Do you really want to hack into the last second?
Okay.
Do you know how this could end up? But you will basically not do demo. Don't do last check on the same things. Anyway, are you ready now?
Yes.
So, okay, go.
Okay. Hi, everybody. Nowadays, we have thousands of devices and services with OpenAPI. And there are thousands of ways how we can connect them. And actually, programmers spend days and weeks on the work to connect the devices. And our platform is simplify their work, and actually by our platform people can make this solution 10 times faster. Let me introduce you Megabot. Megabot should be there in 10 seconds. By our platform, people can connect external services by graphical design. There are no single line of code, so everybody with basic programming skill can use it and combine external services. Our monetization system is very simple. We'll take a small monthly fee from our users, and our target audience is actually you, the programmer. The next step is we made actually a smart house. We connected Internet of Things smart house to Messenger Telegram. And now we can make a tea with Telegram Messenger. Does anybody have a phone with internet?
Nobody.
Yeah. One, two. Can you give me phones for 30 seconds?
Yeah.
Now we will make. We will make phone. We will make G with only Telegram, and it's a very good example how people can use our platform. You can. You should know that it's only one of the decisions that people can make by our platform. There are thousands of ways how we can use platform. Actually, people can combine all the devices with OpenAPI, and it doesn't matter on the device. Our mission after the hackathon is to provide service better, and that everybody can use our services without programming skills. Like everybody, it doesn't matter you are a programmer or no, you can use our service and connect several devices.
Okay.
Did you?
Okay, now it's time for questions. Do we have questions now? Oh.
I think it's
waiting. When will be my coffee? It's waiting. Coffee ready? No?
So?
The coffee machine is broke.
Really?
Yeah.
Is my cell phone is broken?
No, I don't know. Maybe.
I think it will be in several minutes.
This is metal
glasses. Woo! Yeah!
Oh, this is my coffee.
Woo! Okay. Okay, got it. So now I have time for questions.
Well, the coffee machine is great, but...
Tea machine.
Tea machine, sorry. But how actually your stuff is different from the coffee machine there in the kitchen?
But and use microphone like that. Thank you.
I said that it's only one of the decisions that people can make by our platform. Our platform connects all the devices and services that use OpenAPI. It's like if Tesla will have OpenAPI, you can go to our platform. After 30 minutes, you can connect Tesla to your mobile phone, and you can say a Tesla to go to home, or you can say Tesla to start, or you can say it to other device, or what do you want?
Okay. Yes, we have a few more, but currently you haven't already moved here because you are next after like two questions.
Hi, you are showing just the limitation of your product, but there is not your problem, because I listened that you make something like Corazoid.
Yeah.
It's better to present because it's your like zooming gun here.
Yeah.
Because everybody can make what, but Corazoid is wow. So please, can you tell a few more words about it?
I can show it.
So. Interesting.
1 minute?
Yes. So we will use this class.
I can tell. Well, based on my own experience, I started this course learning about how to create chatbots and business processes. After a couple of months, I realized that it takes too many steps, and as a programmer, I understand it could be done faster. So that's why I created a graphical logic designer. So I can do the same thing as a Corazoid, but faster. Some parts of it can also compare with the Zapier system, which allows you to connect multiple templated services, like it's hundreds of them, more than 500 between each other. But Zapier, it's really plain. You pretty much you get one event, you do some ifs then, and you just send it straight to another service. It's you cannot configure it like complex logic. It's not platform.
Okay, let me explain you. There are two services main. Our main competitors. There is Corazoid and there is
Zapier.
Yeah. Corazoid is a service that provides only graphical decision. Zapier provides connection services. So if you want to make this smart solution, you need to go to Zapier and then go to the Corazoid. By now, platform is mixed. It's combined. So you don't need to use two services, it's just one.
Okay, so what's this?
Yes, it's our platform. Usually, actually, you can see structure and on each part of the way user, you can see the code, and actually, you can programming your machine and learn.
So that's pretty much how this thing moves.
Okay, got it. Okay, thank you, guys.
It's been boiled, now it's cooling down.
Next tea will.
Yeah, next tea will. So please, Scoopy already, sorry, not Scoopy. Scroll it, please already move.
Actually, it's very taste testing.
Yes. So, thank God, it's not coming along.
Thank you.
So, please, Scrolly, come here, because we need to be more people to do something. And after Scrolly, the next team will be Biosense, so please prepare, move to the left, because you have to be next one here. But first, will be Scrolly. Okay, so, guys, are you ready? So here's the microphone. Yes. I have seen that already on Friday. Okay, ready? Go.
Hello everyone, my name is Alexander and I want to show you the new way how you can structure and display your information to itself or to the others. I am currently working as a head of IT and daily I receive tons of messages, notifications, mails, events, messages from WhatsApp which I have to process and dedicate the most important information. I spent a lot of time and this is a real pain for me to get business information from messages at WhatsApp and notifications at social networks. So this pain pushed me and our team to make a new way to structure this information, and you may show it right now. So, we are offering a platform which consists of mobile application, cloud and screens which can be placed anywhere you want, anywhere you need first of all, and you may structure and display information there. So, the first component is a cloud app which consists, contains smart services which process and structure information either at your device or at any other devices who subscribed here. The mobile application controls the screens and controls the display information to the dedicated screen. So our concept is to display important information to the screen we need right now. Where we can react and interact with this information. So as soon as we see this info, we can write time, interact, and we see it momentarily. So our audience is people from 25 to 50 years. This primary category, these are developers who can connect to our platform. And entrepreneurs, but it doesn't mean that at all. We can push this concept to more old people, for example, for parents, for our grandparents, even if they doesn't have a mobile phone. So we can display him the most important information, for example, to take pills or any important things. And we can see whether they reacted or not by our messages. So we are going to run a Kickstarter company and to evaluate the our market and gather money for running up. So this is our idea, and we are sure that you need it because everyone has a lot of.
Yes, time's up. Thank you. Woo.
Thank you very much.
I have a question. What do you think, how much this device can cost?
The cost of the device depends on the size of the device. It will be from 10 bucks for the small device, if you need it, to $100 if it's more larger. If you, in future, we may produce more larger screens, but they would be more costly.
Got it.
Do we have more questions from the audience?
What platform you use software, what tools have you used to develop this?
What platform do you have used?
What platform? We use the cloud platform right now with Parser Server, which can deploy us services based messaging and API. So we can connect different services like mobile apps, like other services to push information and to process it.
Okay. And last question.
Did you investigate also market on big flat electronic papers? What is the maximum size? What
you can use? Right now the maximum size is 42 inches, but it's too expensive right now. It's expensive even 30 inches. It's pretty expensive. But we show you the concept which will work on either any screen you need. It could be, for example, the main screens of your home. It could be persistent and more larger.
Okay.
Not a paper, but the same functional.
Thank you.
Woo! Thank you.
So BioSense is already moving the stuff here because you are next year. Who's the team lead? I will give microphone. BioSense.
You.
Me.
BioSense.
BioSense. Who's the BioSense? So, and after BioSense, I don't know, like, sometimes it's really hard to understand, isn't it? So we'll be IMCO? IMCO. So, yes, so you are next one, please be ready, and don't look me like as a face like I'm the Jesus Christ superstar. So, but first we will see BioSense, who is almost ready, is doing all the things, what's the new setup. So, are you ready to start now? And once more, you can go to the Facebook page and go to the special photo album where all team photos are and go like and comment the teams which you have liked so we can know what is the favorite of the audience. And now, we just connecting these some cables. No signal cable indeed. And then we have all signal.
Okay, hi guys. My name is Andrew. Does anybody know that every second in the world one people dies through the bad quality of food and environment? When I finish my pitch, the number of deaths it will be 600. But we have solution to solve this problem, and our goal to of our team is decrease the number of deaths in the world. For today, for diagnostics of food product, you must take this product, go to the laboratory, and wait for a week. With our device, you can make it per 15 minutes. A few words about our market. For today, we concentrate in agricultural company with chicken and pig. We have talks with this company. They can buy these samples, 50 samples per year for diagnostics. It will be cost $20. And in Ukraine, we have 1,000 farming like that. And we will have $500,000. It's half million net income per year only for selling these samples, but we can solve a service net application, and we can develop our device in medicine and other things. Now a few words about our device. For diagnostics, we must take a mobile phone application and our biosensor. We must put a sample in our biosensors, close it, and push the button on. Okay, this is our biosensors. We are close it and push the button on. If you pay attention, we have six samples, two up level of speed for diagnostics in six times. After that, we open our program, named Biosense, login. Login and you can stay. Okay. We are logging, and in the main screen of application we will have we will write the field, the date, the culture, some seeds, and affection, what we want to fix it. It's some aflatoxins or some bacteria. And after that, we are pushing the button on for start scanning. Okay, we push the button for start. Okay, I will help. Sorry. Okay, we have result. Our seeds for diagnostics is okay, and after that we have a left menu. In this menu we can show results of our diagnostics, what we are doing yesterday or last week or last month, and we have a map. On this map we fix it where we are making a diagnostic, and that's all. Thank you.
So I will start with questions first. Please explain what exactly did you do over the weekend, because you came up with some solution. What was the progress?
What was the progress? In Friday we make a plan. First of our plan here, it's we're building a 3D model of our device and printing this 3D model. This orange model was printed here in a 2D printer. It was the first and the second. We write this program. We had some problem with this problem, but they have solved it.
Okay. And what is your prediction?
And we make a Facebook page.
Got it.
For the,
so what is your prediction when you are hoping to launch that into the market? When actually can farmers start to use it, or whatever clients? Market. When somebody can start to use it, like when you can start to sell those solutions?
I think so, it's a half year.
Okay, got it. Do we have question from the jury or from the audience? No? Thank you! Woo! The next thing is already moving here. Oh, thank God, say actually he did take my notes seriously. So, and after this one we see how you pronounce it. Chablo.
You're gonna have Chablo.
Yes. Chablo, you're next one, so please move already here. But first we will see the team which is doing some light magic. So the long name of that team is
Intelligent light system.
Okay.
Controller.
Yeah. Okay. So who is the team lead who will take microphone? You? So you ready?
Hello, my name is Daniel Victor. I'm an electronics developer, and I want you to introduce a product in code. It's intelligent light controller. It's aimed to help you to save the energy at home, and also it makes your life more comfortable. We all know the problem when we in the evening go from the room to the room, we have to switch the light manually. If you will use IMCO, it can do it for you. It's managed to do that by counting how many people is in the room. Our solution is better than others because it's easy to mount and it's have lower price compared to the digital cameras. And it gives you much comfort. We are going to sell separate devices for the first time, and after that we are going to connect them into the Internet of Things and send the data to other home devices. we plan to start, first we plan to improve the algorithm of recognition, and then we are want to go to the Kickstarter to research the demand on the product. Our team consists from two software developers, me as the leader and the web developer, and also we have the marketer. That's all, thanks, and now I show you how it works.
Can somebody explain what actually is happening here? Let's just explain and then go.
I want to.
We are entering the room. There are two people. And then he goes out. And then I goes out.
And so these are mostly questions. Can you explain why this is useful and needed first, once more?
I think it will be useful like for the people who want to save the budget, like if you have much rooms and you forget to turn off the light, you will waste much money. And also if you want to have your life more comfortable, like to forget to manually control the switch button of the light and just walk around your house. So this solution will be useful for you. And also you will care about the environment because you will save the energy.
Okay. Do we have, yes, we have two questions. First here.
Okay. Okay, great. So how it is better than the very simple and easy to use motion detectors, which switch on and switch off the light?
Because they didn't count how many people are in the room, they just work for 5 minutes. So when you sit to read the book, after 5 minutes you have to stand up and go to activate it for another 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Great. We have one more question from here.
You want to remove manual controller, but what if I want to stay light on when I'm in the room?
Yeah, I know. If you want to see. Okay, so there is many solutions for it, like you can control it from your smartphone, but it's for future. Now we didn't have it.
Okay.
But it's not easy to have to solve this problem.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Woo! So the next team, Diablo, is already setting up the sinks, and I will choose the team which will be next on the stage, which is intelligence building. So you should already move here, because you will be here next. But first, we will see Diablo. Is the microphone working? Can we do this one? Yes, ready. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Go.
So, hi guys. I know you're tired, but concentrate, because we are going to talk about crazy things that change your life. So, have you ever headache about money or finance? Yeah. Do you really dream about some trip, but think you can get it because it's a little bit expensive? Our solution is Diablo. It's an intelligent system that can help you in the easiest way manage your finance and budget. So Diablo is an artificial intelligence system that can help reduce finance problems for individuals, for small and big company, or even banks. So let me demonstrate incredible things that we have in our system. This is Andrew. He's dreamed about trip to Spain, but his sim is too expensive for him. So we provide for our system monthly statement from his bank, and we start do some magic. We provide some budget system to motivate our user use it and make some fun. Oh, looks like Andrew IKEA fan.
Yeah.
So, we predict your future expenses, analyzing your previous expenses, and you can view on our screen some suggestion from our partner. And it's not just advertisement, it's based on your previous experience, and it's really personalized because your bank has to know it better than your friend. Also, it's not all our feature. We have amazing, awesome features. Andrew can ask directly our system, can I trip to Spain? And when it will be possible? So, when Andrew asks it, we analyze how tickets cost to transport, what is the price of accommodation, what is price of accommodation, and how many your expenses will be in previous trips, and based on a saving from your account, we'll prognose the best value date for this trip. So looks like this can be in July, but better in August, we have traveled to Spain, of course. So, also, we can, it's self-natural, because we can propose some things that you should buy because you dream about it and your bank know it. So it's terrific opportunity for banks to include the system to online banking, and terrific opportunity for small and big organization to sell our product now.
Thank you, time is up. Okay, time for questions. Yes, I know, I didn't know you have questions.
I've got two questions actually, more technical one. The first one, what do you accept right now as input? You imported the file, so what's was in that file, if you can show, it would be great. And the second question is like, what do you use behind to make the analysis?
So, but it's really simple bank statement. So we analyze it in the Cortana Analytics suite, have some rules, have some predictions, and convert them to dollars to be more simple for auditor, and analyze in which market you must buy some things, and etc. From example, yeah, you travel a lot, you buy flights, some tickets to make some fun.
Sorry, can I interrupt it here? So, yes. Is your system smart enough to recognize different formats of the statements from the bank?
I think we can some unified statement because. No, all statement has amount, some store, some date, so it's possible to collect with all banks.
Okay, so then the second question I had, like, what do you use to make predictions and the business intelligence section?
We use Azure Cortana Analytics suite, so we prepare some rules.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, do we have more questions from jury or from audience? No. Okay, last one, okay.
Okay, maybe a sneaky question. How do you get the data out of banks while at the same time being comfortable for the users so they don't have to upload, download? Right?
So, reason bank is our customer because bank should buy our system to make his customer feel happy. More happy, and bank can motivate his customer do more transaction because we suggest some services in our system.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. So the next team who is setting up the things is intelligent building. So you guys are here and we set up the thing. Where is the team? Come on guys. Intelligent building, run here. Okay. And after this one, when we see team, his name is Goofy. You are the last one then. And then the jury have to go and make decisions and we have the break. Hopefully this break will be not more than 20-25 minutes. But first we have team, which is a building. but who is now ready to show what was done? And you guys started yet from the scratch, or did you have anything before event? Did you, the things that you show here was done here, or you had anything before event as well?
No, no, all things really done here.
So everything that you see now here, because we have different teams here. Some teams had already some things before event, but some things started here, and this team now that you see did things from the scratch. Are you ready?
Yep.
Okay, go.
I can start, yeah?
Yep.
Hello, my name is Yaroslav, and I would like to present to you our project. This is Intelligent Building, the system for monitoring and efficient controlling the life cycle of multi-flat building that can help you save the money. How many people are currently living in the multi-flat building? And how many people was scared last month looking at the utility tariffs? Yeah, it's very scary, it's very high. And it seems that they're not going to falling down. But do you know that you can save up to 40% your money if you just start using the energy inside your flat and inside the whole building more efficiently? But how can you, where can you find this efficient? We know where, and we believe that using IoT and the smart technology, we can teach your building to use energy more smart. So what we are going to do, we are going to install a lot of sensors through the building and let them communicate with the server. One server collects enough data, he can make a decision what can you do to reduce your energy usage. And as well as notify you or us or service providers that something happens inside the building or something broken here. Here on the garage we made a working prototype, and unfortunately for now it consists only from one sensor. It measured temperature and sent it to the server that based on the Azure technologies. And once the temperature comes up some value, it notify us for using web interface that something wrong on a particular building and where exactly the problem is. So we're going to start from the cooperation with services providers that works with such a building. And yesterday we agreed with one of such providers that have five such buildings that we can start using our prototype here. So yeah, I think it's good for us, it's a good start point for our team. So thank you very much. This is all.
Thank you. Time for questions. Do we have any from the jury or audience? So, what? Yes.
Do you kind of predict how much the apartment building can save the money with this program? This
As I said, up to 40%. It depends on how many, how many things we can control, how fast we will notify if something broken, for example, or works not properly.
Yes, we have one more.
Yeah? Yes, yeah, simple question. How do you make money?
I think that it will be like a full stack solution for such building. So we are going to solve all their problems, and as I said, we will cooperate with service providers. So we installed our solution into the building, and we know all the problems, and we notify the service providers if something wrong, and they come to the building, and there is our service, and we would like to provide this service.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. And last thing for that event is already going to the States. I will give microphone also for the team lead. Interesting what they will show us now. So if I'm not I think I'm correct that you are the guys from Sigmund.
Yes.
Yes, it's a team from the most biggest outsourcing company in Ukraine who was focusing the problem that you had in Friday was the coffee machines are too complicated. So let's see. This doesn't seem as a coffee machine anymore. It seems that they had the different problems already.
It's even better.
You know, it's interesting, good like Cyclone or whatever IT company, although having in office Coca-Cola, whiskey, and this is Captain Morgan. This is the room. I have, by the way, never seen mixed whiskey and Coca-Cola. So it's interesting. Maybe somebody wanna come and test how it will be tomorrow morning. Check those things. But so guys, are you ready now?
Can we switch to the camera at first?
Yes, the camera. Where's the switchman?
We have a man.
Special man.
Switchman. Okay.
So and we'll go back to that website later.
Yes.
Hello everyone, my name is Boris and I've come here with my team. I love them very much. It's 8 very talented guys with a strong, solid technical background who are willing to change the world. And our product is called ScoofyNet. ScoofyNet is a machine learning system for ecosystem for smart machines. So you can easily connect your device to our system and get something more out of that. So, a lot of people day by day have a lot of challenges. For example, to order, for example, you want to order something, and this they should take into account your personal taste, and or sometimes you even don't know what you want to order, and we want to bring some personality to the machines that the machine will know something more about you. So ScoofyNet is a machine learning system for connected distributed machines which accumulate and aggregate information about you. So let's imagine that you have you traveling, for example, you travel to Japan and you want to have your evening drink, your favorite margarita. So you come to the bar and you see these names. This, for example. I don't know what that's. I don't know what does it mean for me, but I want my margarita. And even if some guys speak English, he don't know what is my favorite taste. And everything what I need, I just need to come to the machine, authorize, touch the button, and machine start doing the magic. The cloud predict, so what is my favorite usual taste, and create a especially my drink for my taste with my proportions. So this is cocktail for Yuri. Yuri is a runner, and this system takes into account his health condition from bracelet and without alcohol. I'm not so good as Yuri, and sometimes I am really tired of my work. So, where is my mobile? Okay, here's. I also can authorize, so open the app, because now we unfortunately didn't implement the voice control, but I can authorize and create my cocktail. Okay, I choose Goofy, as usual, trust me, again, this is a live demo, so it could be, enjoy, okay, so now system should start, you see, it start preparation, of course, alcohol, not so fast as a coke, but it's slowly but surely make my favorite, because that machine know that I love a little bit of whiskey and cola. And this can be, it's only one application of our system. That, as you know, we plan to have coffee machines, and this is our target audience, the IT companies in Ukraine, and smart coffee machines for developers, because no one drink at work, yes? So that's why we show you mixer, and this product can be extended. But our target audience is IT companies and smart coffee shops
some coffee bars in Kyiv, which will install our machines and bring it, make it for you. So what's about team? And by the way, how we do this prediction? So now we can we switch to the website, because we have something here. It's very important key point.
Okay.
So it's here, and this is clusterization map. So we do this prediction. We did analysis of our users, and we see that I'm in a red area of drinkers who love whiskey. We have also green area for Captain Morgan, no alcohol drinks, as you see in this cluster. So we do machine learning, and I would like to invite here my team. Please come here. So without them, we have a really solid team. And that's why it's happening. Because of the team, you see that we have developers, hardware developers, Taras, where are you? Okay. So all together, and unfortunately Igor was damaged yesterday. You see that, but it's not affect our demo. We implement machine learning, but we not have no time to implement voice recognition. So thank you for attention. We try to did our best, and I hope in next generation the world of machines will know more about us, because we will be connected to smart engine of machine learning, and we will provide our fitness data, our taste, special notes, what we like, and the machine will do the best for us. So that's, by the way, my drink. I need to drink it.
So let me ask now about the money. So what you see, this thing that it was building, how much you can make money, and first of all, when exactly you can start to make money, like when, how long would the process that this thing would actually be working in some office?
Okay, so we have two options. We have an engine which based on Raspberry Pi and connections. So that's like we want to do prototype in 3 months, wrap this in 3D printer case, and improve our API. By the way, in our ecosystem, we use Azure. It was really I answering the question in 3 weeks. In 3 months, we will show the real working prototype up to ready. And I speak already with the CTO of Sikrum. He said that it sounds interesting. We can try. And the head of personnel, he said, oh, it's completely, we'll enjoy our, make fun for our developers. We should try. So we have a high executive level approval from my company, from Sikrum. And I think in 3 months we can pitch to IBAN, Luxoft about that system and create some small Ukrainian networks for developer at least. And will be our target audience for, because we are live love technology, and it could be interesting for geeks as developers.
Is there any other use case where you can use this thing?
You take a look on the machine, so it's an example. Yes, we also have a second idea how to move this mixer to the production stage, because we investigate the market. There are a lot of existing very nice, well-made machines for cocktail mixing, but you say, I want and select from the menu what they have. They have no custom and they don't do analytics. So we have the cluster of information, or will have as soon as we will get information at least from our users. And
basically, it would be like a separate machine. You go to the, let's say, bar.
Yeah.
And you just enter whatever, do this magic, and it makes personalized cocktail for you.
Yes, and it can be embedded in the dance floor, so you don't need to go. You know, it's a kind of loudy. It's like, I want a shot. I want, and you're still waiting 10 minutes here. But there is no need to wait. You just come, authorize, and it can be paid, because we can subscribe the money from your card.
And everything what we see here was built from the scratch?
I'm really proud why this team here, because I'm really proud to, that's because of them. So we sitting Friday after the lunch, it's a busy time at work, but I say, let's just found the idea. And that's from idea to implementation of that what you see, 48 hours. That's why Garage 48 is just impressed me. That's very nice 48. So in 2 days we create something that I didn't expect. So we concentrated on machine, because we think to crack the machine. But after we decide, okay, let's expand. And we understood that our system, this architecture, can be much broader. So we can, how say, use. So we have options how to integrate with voice recognition to send commands, because something not work, we implement this, embed this engine in the Raspberry Pi, but there is no cloud connection right now, so we face some technical issues. But anyway, I think it's in 2 weeks we will fix.
Okay, do you have external API access? So for example, add authorization, so if I set it up in my company and it's connected to PipeDrive, for example, then it only gives, it only gives coffee when someone makes a sale.
Yeah, so that this is the main goal of our system, to design public API with, so you can test it for free for few requests, but later you will subscribe for billable, and that's what we want to provide to our service. We will provide service as learning engine, and also second direction we will do integration. So we'll help companies to integrate our solution into their machines, so we can connect. Help to connect all these together.
Which makes excellent company.
Yeah.
I hope so. So, I think that we don't see any more questions. So, thank you.
What will be the price?
Okay, pricing. We calculate very roughly. So, this extension for the machines, it's based on Raspberry Pi, so we calculate about $20. So $20 is the price, but the value which a company can get out of the machine, the statistic, the water out of the range, so all that's nice ideas which running around the coffee machine, and also statistic for the bar, who drink, and the most important thing is it's a healthcare, because we track what is my heart rate right now, and can I drink, or I will drive somewhere or not. So put all together, it's $20 for such system. I think.
And number of containers for liquid customized or just
for sure.
Maximum?
No. It's highly extendable because we cannot drink more than three. So that's why we here is three.
Okay. Thank you. Woo! So this is it. Now we have break. I think that being realistic, let's be back here by 7:45, and then we will know who the winners.
Коктейл, Борис. Тарас, не мешай мне в войну.
Тарас, давай. Жми на полную. Меняй пропорции.
Да сейчас мы тебя не мешаем. Давай. Леска, не мешать тебе?
Почему я не хочу это делать?
Я всегда бывал,
что много брака, например, если четыре брака, то перестали отбирать. Они так и задержат 2 часа, которые я потрачу, создая свои фотографии отобрать. Я могу, я могу предложить альтернативы, значит, во-первых, я могу сейчас уже запихнуть после мероприятия, именно победители, когда все обработать еще 80 в течение часа и завтра дождаться остальное. Вот пусть это такая альтернатива. Я не хочу, потому что, во-первых, очень сильно падает качество, потому что они выгрузят отсюда, не обработанное, это будет полное зло.
И потом через час-полтора уже шучок вот с этого вечера команды. Правильно? Все презентации.
Наша ситуация.
сижу. А, и у вас продолжение.
Юра, я выпил алкоголь.
Дуже. Я пропоную вам зараз поговорити всі фунти поїсти, бо що ніхто не хоче сидіти на цій штуці, може.
Ні, ми поки все не
подивимо. Ми нормально так уже. Давайте, слушай, давайте всі схопимося в там, вибіляти туди.
Так, давайте
фонд. Так я думаю, що нас сфотографували.
Так, все одно, давайте самі ще зараз.
Так, давайте самі.
Давайте сами. Нас Аня зафоткує. Я Антон Олександрович. Я буду вас фоткувати.
Я буду вас фоткувати.
Да? Ти не хочеш к нам присоединиться?
Не хочу, конечно. Ми по чесному члену.
По чесному присоединю. А ти шов сюди? Це де Кутя зробив сюди? Ні. Олег?
Олег.
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 Хто поднімав вас? Олег.
А где
Муся? Я не знаю, кого плохо. Один Олег притарабанил бутылки. Вот ухренька. Он делает бухой все. На меня надавил еще. Надавил, сказал, что ты
не наш парень. Вообще на дверке на
друг друга.
Нет, вот это так. Она
покончилась и сначала.
Все?
Ребята? Ребята, фоткаемся.
Короче, мы идем в тайм.
Ну, посмотрим.
Боря и ребята.
Ой, Олег, подложи лицо под эту штуку, а мы это сфоткаем на экране.
Ну давай,
что, мы
что, наливаем, что ли?
Давай.
А где Тарас?
Тарас!
Наливай!
Как вывести? Тарас!
Тарас, дай команду.
Тарас, мы это разговариваем, пора наливать.
Сейчас он идет.
Только Тарас, да, отпихнули.
Кто
это? Ключевые люди в стартапе.
Те, кто
знает,
как налить. Те, кто что? Те, кто? Кто?
Те, кто знает, как налить.
Маша, тебя тоже видно, стань чуть-чуть сюда.
Давайте
Тарас.
У меня, наверное, не знаю, дистаты, я.
В
центрі. Хто людина, яка знає, як наливати?
Так.
Два. Ігор, хватить показувати.
Смотрите в камеру.
В какую?
В кадр. Смотрите, Антон.
Другую. Смотрите в кадр. В кадр.
Да улыбаться или крестить, это у нас.
Сейчас улыбаться. Я теперь серьезные лица.
Нет.
Еще немножко. Ну и вот как-то так. Не, хватит,
страшно. Мы уже перетестировали. Мы позе Ким Чен И нам фоткались, там тоже классно.
Ну ей выставила.
Ну еще разочек, пожалуй. О!
Может быть перемешаться.
По-моему,
ну все, ладно.
Наливай.
Вы знаете, на нашу команду.
Фейсбук, и я ее, короче...
Ты кто?
Ким Чен Ын.
Ну за что?
Ким Чен Ын.
Фотки команды, наши самого тёплого. Блин, там была нормальная звезда.
Так прикольная фотка.
Нет, она же Сибирь Сам. Так, как его
звали? Да, да, да. Да, ладно, давай, шли мне на Facebook, а я ее запущу в нашу.
Спасибо, дорогие коллеги, что пришли нас поддержать, и мы вас за это нальем.
Наливай,
я уже перетестировал уже.
Так, Боря, а как здесь
лайвстрим?
Ха-ха, лайвстрим, привет. Ну, зато стримим, короче, что-то там.
А что мы идем?
А что там? Где сообщение? Так они не рассказывают. Что говорю, зайди в свои, а где твои сообщения?
А, точно, да. У меня
есть право. Нет,
я не знаю. Если бы у нас вот этого не было, вот этого вот, да, что если бы он был, то это все.
А вам какой вообще, кроме вашего проекта, понравился?
Пиво, чипсы, вы здесь?
Я никакой.
Скорее правильно, ваш самый лучший.
Ну как, для пацанов лучшего, но
это не так. Давай обратно, да, ты слушай.
Такие же тебя.
Олежек, ну давай, туда, ты тебя обратно,
пожалуйста.
А то, что он дошел, что мать
задеет. Я потом послал уже тебе, она уже не пришла.
А куда ты?
А, вниз, дети.
О, где-то вот
так.
Там пицца. Бобер, выдыхай, идем пиццу.
Microsoft закрыли моим ноутбуком 100.
8 формат.
Я так правильно. Еще есть.
Там я сам видел. Я вот по порядам
ездил. Я за як ви? Я вже переміг, я вже задоволений, що у нас відбулося. Ви бачите, ми пішли, ми
шовнули. Ні, ну так, не тому, що деякі запитували,
але просто
деякі готувалися і вже
Так, коли плануєте результати сказати?
Так,
7.45.
45, все, так?
7.45.
Це
годину
ще читати. Ні, так, вже
ж годину. Ну що?
Годину треба брати. 45 хвилин стартів результати.
10
хвилин.
Ну,
я думаю,
у нас
це вже пічі. Вот я делал, когда стращал, что я лох презентации. Я пошел поработал на себе. Да, да. Это же
всегда я поступаю.
Прикинь, мне вот не Олег говорит, вот вообще как сын, говорит, ты лох, ты никого пишешь, нет вообще.
Я думаю, ви йдете, тому що ми тут зумовіжі.
Все остальные.
А куда они все делись? Нет, ну это классная система. Нет, нам надо...
ваша музичка тут не ставить.
Причому почали.
Так а вас кропили?
Ну, сподівалися.
Чим?
Ну, поділяйте саме там. Повною топлю це все знімає. Ну, не знаю. Там, кстати, ще буде кропіло. Тобто, там буде чого ставити. Кропілка, значить, не буде сидіти. Ні, ні, я хочу.
Так, заводимо.
девушка, хуй вам.
Маша ответила, хуй вам.
Все стоят.
Как вы видите?
Я ответила, хуй вам. Чай, есть шоколад?
Юра, белый шоколад.
Снабжал шоколад. Белый уже закончил, я сижу, замените колено.
Я потом что и там есть другой.
Час.
Да. Уже 7.45. Да. Ну, вот правда, просто расписание 8. Вот, значит, минимум 7.45.
Не, я здесь в спальне сижу, да, жду в отеле.
Да. Спасибо. сравнению с
Я начинаю сейчас. синхронизация с Ажуром. Начинает скорость 7 раз в сутки, 2,5 килобита в час.
Check one, two, so guys, let's go.
come back now after fights, fighting poor, doing other nasty things. We have going to drinking cocktails and alcohol, doing some naked wrestling. We have reached to the understanding who should be the teams which was standing out for the jury. It doesn't mean that some others are losers or something. It just means that at this point those teams was a bit more. But anyway, let's invite all the team members and everybody here, because we want to start like immediately.
Kai will have this, yeah, I don't.
Kai is
that.
Yes, we have a business. I don't know where.
Everybody please come back now, we have a teacher. Everybody, let's come to that. We have a teacher.
Это полезно, что вы видите, что вы видите, где бы захватился, то есть если бы вы с ним
заполнили, some place
like a
like only work around you can try like
no, don't open it.
Sorry,
sorry. You can't. Yeah, I'll have to go. Yeah.
So, okay guys, so as I said, after a long fight, naked wrestling, watching porn, drinking lots of alcohol, we have reached into the point when we have made decision that we don't want to watch many more porn, we just want to come back here. So in many sense, this was very entertaining and special event, our first hardware event in Ukraine, very hardware. So. Very mixed ideas, so that's why I predicted to be in this jury decision shorter, but it wasn't. So we really discussed, looked into every team, looked into every idea, and tried to understand what teams has potential and what ideas has potential to go to the market and make us a great success story from Ukraine, because that's why we are here. We want to help you to build next successful startup. Not meaning that you need to sell something, but you need to make company or organization which makes impact, which growing, and if this business is profitable indeed. So, but first, before we will start on our spinners, I will give microphone to the Anastasia from Estonian Embassy.
Hey guys, thanks so much. I hope that everybody's back from the break, and I think we will use this time to make sure that everybody's here for the final results. You see the logo, it's on most of the products that you have. Your t-shirts have that, which means that the project is supported by the Estonian Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Just like many other projects in Ukraine. And Estonia has been helping Ukraine for many years now, and in last year, for example, for 2015, the amount of aid has grown and has reached the number of 2,700,000 euros, and we're hoping that it will continue to increase and it will be aimed at positive projects. And according to the 2016 strategy for Estonian and Ukrainian cooperation, education, ICT, support for business environment are the priorities. And as you see, as I usually say, the Garage 48 is the best example of those projects, because you get to come here and, you know, with all the experience and knowledge that you do have already, you have the as they call them, senior IT guys coming in and mentoring you and providing additional knowledge. And, you know, in addition, just as a fun part, they also have names like in Game of Thrones. So it's always a fun thing to have. So without further ado, I'd like to just repeat that, you know, the Estonian Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Estonian Embassy here in Ukraine are really excited to support this project and to be a partner of it. And if you have any great ICT projects involving potential for Ukraine's development, you can also come and talk to me later, and I can provide you with information how you can develop that. Without anything else in addition, good luck, and I hope the best one wins, and that you've had a lot of fun, and you will come to other events that will be taking place this year in Ukraine. Thanks.
Basically, yes, making this event is big effort, and we are super thankful that the biggest supporter is the Estonian government. But we had also other supporters starting from Microsoft. Let's make big up to Microsoft. Woo! And the ISEC, Brain Basket Foundation, and all of them which is now here. So let's make big up to all our partners. Woo! So, yes, the winners will have prizes, and the lovely lady will now talk about them.
Ragnar is calling him Masha.
Yeah. Isn't it Masha? She looks like a Masha, isn't it? in Estonia, right? In Ukraine, Masha.
Really, Ragnar has put his glasses on because he's just so blinded by my beauty.
I'm blinded by the winners.
All right, so quickly about the prizes. So like I said on Friday, you're here to win this thing, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Someone is. Anyway, so we have a few cool things for you. So first, one team gets to go to this computer art festival, new cool hipster stuff in Lviv. Also, we're gonna have two free places for two teams for free prototype testing in Expo Zone. And also, Microsoft is putting out four activity bands for you. So let's see who are the winners.
Not yet.
Not yet.
No. It's except everybody, so we're trying to stay here. So before we go to the winners, again, you know, making this thing, it's just bigger effort. It's, first of all, making this event happen is a big effort, and I really want to give a big hand to the main team who has been behind it, because I'm just, you know, showing up here, you know, doing this nice face and beating you into everywhere, but there are people who are working really hard to make this happen, because there are 1,000 small details. Making this event happen, the quality which only satisfies us, is a hard thing. So that's why I want to call now here two team members. One is actually in Estonia, and she has been helping us all these 48 hours.
She's watching this.
Yeah, so first, let's first give a big hand to the Karin. Woo! Because we have been working with that idea like 2 months and more. But we had also a lovely team who was supporting her, who was here making it happen. So first of all, Sky.
Woo!
Marta! And Marianne, come here. Woo! So in Ukraine, how do you call a girl like that? What's the Ukrainian girl name for the Marianne?
Marta.
Oksana.
Oksana, okay. So this is Oksana and Marta. Let's make it to Oksana and Marta. Thank you. Nice, so you can go back and speak Ukrainian, I hope, yeah? Did you learn any Ukrainian language over the weekend?
What is it?
So can you say any Ukrainian word at all? Hunger kaput? Molot kaput? What that means?
It's a local dish, very special cuisine.
Okay, I don't know that one. I have been amazed that you made first time here that one. But we had also mentors, so can we see all mentors who was mentoring that? Please come, Indrek, Ronno, and who else we have? And, okay,
sorry, I forgot you.
Come here, you know, come on. Because, you know, big part of our event is like, pushing the great people help you. So let's, did these guys help you?
Yeah! Yeah.
Thank you! Woo. Thank you! Thank you! Okay, I think that now we can talk about winners. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, not so bad. So, pretty good actually. So, once more, how we made decision and what was behind that. So, jury decision was really looking that one. We look much deeper than idea. Idea itself is a good, but it's not enough. So the main thing is like why we do this event is also see how much you can learn over the weekend, how much you can develop, how much you can just jump out of comfort zone and work hard. So because this progress what you have done is really important. Other things, as we are going around over the weekend, we also look what's the key team chemistry. Because the most hardest and most usual thing is like team will break up and that's it, the idea is dead. And indeed, if we have team great, the great team, and we have great progress, so we clearly look, okay, what is this idea that's working? Does it have real potential to grow into something big? Does it really has potential that they can grow into the business or in big scale, whatever, non-profit organization, which we this time we don't have too much. So this is kind of criteria and then we discuss. Every jury member will give their view and then we kind of reach into the some final agreement. But always, the good news is that always all your guys and girls and animals and whatever, you know, who is part of the community, can always vote and give your own view what did you thought was the best. So that's why first, Ranno will come here and will announce who was favorite of the audience and he will also talk why this is so great team and so great idea.
I like
that. You want this mic? I don't know. Yes, this is the
slowest one. Hello? Yeah. I like the idea because so much diseases all over the world. And this idea is, this team is helping to prevent diseases by creating a testing machine. And also, this team was a favorite of the audience. So, this is Biosense.
Woo!
Biosense, my son.
All team came here, please. Please come here. You want to see? You had only 3 people, really? You had a bigger team, no?
One member team
go around. Go around, already. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
thank you for a picture.
So let's be on the stage now because I'm going to make a photo about you. We have cameraman.
Stand in the line.
Stand in the line. Ah, this is the good place because
wait, I
want to
take a picture of you.
Come on.
Okay, I'm
going to
take a picture of you.
Yeah,
paper. Let's make thank you, man. Go away. So let's make big hand to the winner of the audience. Woo! Thank you. So, come on, it's such a lovely weekend, such a humble ideas. I will give you a microphone, guys. Don't be shy. So, Kai really liked one idea, and not only she liked, but there are many people who liked the jury. And so she will announce special prize. She will tell why, what is the prize, and where she can go. So please.
Okay. So.
We have a big love with microphone.
Right, switch them around.
So, I'm here to announce a special prize. And I'd like to say first that it's my first time in Ukraine, and it's been awesome. So it's mostly for me, when I go to garage events, it's about the people. So all of you, I've made such good friends. Thanks for the local organizers. You guys showed us Ukraine yesterday, the bar duck. And there we go, yeah. So it's really cool to come to events and meet a lot of people, make new friends, and really actually have fun. So this team and this prize is mainly, not mainly, but most, in a big sense, it's about having fun. And also, you know, it's my first time in Ukraine, and I don't think I've ever been that satisfied. So I'm happy that the jury agreed that we can give out the most satisfying team's prize. And this will, of course, go to Borneiro!
Thank you, guys. And what is even more amazing is that you guys can and should, that you are the best team to go to the Lviv, isn't it? Because you will go to this decoded festival to show art.
And just before Borneiro goes off the stage, I just want to mention their very special team, not only what they have done for, you know, all of us, and what they're going to offer in satisfaction. They also have a very special member in their team. It's Dharma. It's his 15th garage event.
This is the Estonian turning into Ukrainian project. And this was the guy, just to know all the girls, you know, he needs some visa issues sorted out. So single ladies look that guy, because we need to take him down because he needs some Ukrainian whatever visa stuff for
me. I already have a Ukrainian name too.
Oh, but, and what is that? So what's your Ukrainian name?
My Ukrainian name is Taras or Tarik.
Tarik. Thank you, guys. Thank you. So moving on. I'm happy that next team who is runner up, it's not like some kind of like systems that this is the third place, second place, whatever. So we felt that there was like team which really stood out. So that's why we decided that this team has to be runner up. And it was pretty much my favorite, that's why I chosen to speak about that team. And for me, usually, which I really look deeply into is the team, as I said already. Also, how was it developed? I also look the market. Also look how interesting market, how much the team or team, whatever, knows about that market. What it makes sense, can you make money, all of those things. And I did like also like when I see that people are really driven to do that thing. And you know, we had also pre-event, some teams showed up, some didn't, not. So which I didn't like that guy and the team that they really was, you know, listening to us, make changes. So they are very great to mentor, because in this road you need to listen and, you know, listening is some skill than now. So with all of those things, we just came up and decided that Ragnarok and Sable can go to the free prototype in Expo soon. Yes? Yeah, okay. So they can just really, should really build prototype and show in one event. And the runner-up is the team which is Snoop! So basically this is the robot guys, you know, these the, yeah, the guys who are building robots for their warehouse, so really nicely done. So this is the teammate, let me give you for everybody else your diploma, and yes, so I'm just giving you here. So as I said, you know, let's make big hand, let's yeah, we are streaming live as well. Let's make photo of them and let's make big hand to the robot! The team lead really mentioned also one very important thing, what is part of that event is team building. That's really great event when you can try out your team members and find new team members. So that's why, you know, you have many things now in the place, so just don't fuck it up now, okay? Can you promise that one at least?
We're gonna fuck up a lot.
Thank you! Thank you, guys, there you go. Okay, so, and Indrek, who is very smart hacker, or the guy who has really been in that field very long, and was running in Estonia Accelerator, and he has been always like involved in our hardware hackathon, so he's the professional guy here. He knows the field, you know. So he will talk about other runner-up and then why this was so special to you.
Yes, this team surprised me, probably most from all the teams. They did something which every team should do, which often is not done, they listen. And applied the advice. They followed one of my central ideas, what I always like to talk about is the best hardware is the one you don't have to build. So after messing around with sensors and communication, they decided, okay, gonna drop that and we're gonna concentrate on our core business. And not building hardware is pretty good because they don't also have to build any buildings. They just have to manage them. So our runner-up is Intellicheck Building Systems. Woo!
So come on guys, let's make a big hand to the runner-up in the building system. Woo!
Right, picture time.
You know, you should jump into that. You should jump into the hands. Exactly. No, come on, you should carry that guy.
Like a surfboard.
Yes, like a surfboard. Yes. One moment, boss. Thank you. So, yes. So now we have, let me see what we have to talk more. Because if I will do that, you will not listen to me anymore. Very important information. You know, next Ukrainian event, will be very soon, actually. So because, you know, I have been in Ukraine in three cities, you know, all of them is lovely. Kiev, Lviv, and when it's sun out, when it's summer nearby, and best place to go is Odessa, isn't it? Did you like Odessa?
Yeah.
Woo! So that's my next event is in Odessa, and in the beginning of May, you know. So, and we will focus in Odessa event gamification. So that's why you got guys who has some passion about that, and actually gamification can be used anywhere. So gamification can be even in the B2B. The sun was coming out system. Well, actually, sun is now out already, so I just have to remove my sunglasses. So that's my next event, so in the beginning of May in Odessa. So guys, if you really liked what we did here and you want to test out something which gamification, come here. Because important things, once more, Masquerade guys really hassled a lot before they did this 100 million project. Eugene was in every event what we had, learned every time. So that's the way it is, you should learn all the time, learn. It's not about just coming us into our event, but it's every time looking new options where to learn. And, but I think that, are you ready for the overall winner?
Yeah!
Oh, no, you can't go. What was that? Guys, there's texting and there's something for sleep. So, are you ready for the overall winner?
Yeah!
Thank you! Because, come here now, because Microsoft will now tell, first of all, what's the prices, and I will give you hints that there is some for next one, mister. So, here's the prices. Nice one. So,
nice one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Go.
So, first of all, it was very, very great pleasure for us to host you during this couple of days here in our office. You're always welcome to any of our events. And it's very, very, I'm very, very proud to be here to announce the team, which really impressed us with the teamwork, with being really, really, really passionate about what they do, coming up to an idea and making it work fully, from the architecture, from the app, up to making the cocktails. So I'm inviting here the winner. The team is Goofy. And I believe the prizes would help you to build your product even better, because it's Microsoft Band, which will enable you to get the insights from your customers to get even better, to make even better machines. So,
I don't know, this is very picture time. Super good example, right? If you just think, if they came up here, what they did show, what was the idea, and what was final result. And maybe super important thing, by the way, guys, we actually understood that you totally misunderstood how big is market. Right? Market is so much bigger. You can use this thing that you're building with so many different use cases, and you can make real money out of that. So basically, this original idea is just totally fucked up, to be honest. Because you just can't make money out of that. There's just three IT companies in Ukraine. Are you guys serious or something? So even actually part industry is like small. But you had even some bigger ideas, but this thing what really can be used, no?
I think it is used everywhere, not just about the cocktails and coffee machines. It's about getting insights from the people and make something personal to them. So the market is huge.
It was our idea, but we dropped the sub-product. Don't worry.
Great, so just, you know, now you have opportunity to show, and you know, if you're super hard working, you never know, it can be next 100 million startup. Thank you. Thank you guys, and actually, did you saw what they did on the stage? So this is the team building, you know, this is the spirit.
Let's
so
drink more.
Yeah, you can drink more. So basically, what is happening next? Sad news. You have to clean shit what you have done. So guys, just, don't leave things here. Let's be respectful for our environment and Microsoft Office. So the first thing is, you know, as I said, what would happen, and let me be clear now. That is, at this moment, that is, every team can show that you are fucking Finnish if you want. Because actually what counts is now that you have real results, that you have real product after some time period. And there is nobody else who's deciding beside you. You have to show the world that you can do that. You have to show the world that you have great team, great idea, and there is a real problem what you're solving, a real solution. So in this sense, this is just one weekend decision. But building a company will start now. So that's why the first thing, you should decide how many teams will stay together. Usually at least half will break up, and that's fine, because this event is more about training and learning. But some teams might stay together. In this sense, please make some rules and agreements and ask honestly, do you really want to do that or not? And just, you know, make those agreements same way. We are doing it, we are spending whatever, 20 hours per week, because you have still your daily job and so on. Be honest and make those tough rules. And this is super hard also for the team lead, because you have to lead that project. Not only that agreement, but many things that will follow. And many times, team lead is so crucial guy or girl who is deciding majority of the success in the future. Also keep in mind that things what you are building is your team, intellectual property. If somebody leaves, it a little bit mess up the thing, so just keep this in mind. Most important, you have to keep the energy and, you know, enjoy it, you know. And other things, you need to focus. If you are thinking of this great idea, how to do progress every week. Not as a like, let's build this feature which will take 6 months. No. Masquerade was out in 2 weeks in Iowa iTunes store. If it will take you, okay, guys, let's be honest, harder thing is much harder. You would never be in the market like in a few months. But you need to make progress. You need to discuss what is our progress. And you need to like, keep winning every week, basically. So that's amazingly important. So by the way, many, and you know, one thing, you have community, you have mentors. Many of them can still help you, like Indra. He's running exactly this kind of accelerator in Estonia, which should help you. You can always approach him and send emails and ask help, you know. Never know, maybe you want to even apply if you feel it is helpful for you. But there are many other things which can help you. Just be open and just even, and also like, don't be shy to ask help and ask feedback. And just, you don't need too fast money because you don't have anything now. So how can investor invest you when you are just basically born yesterday? So in this sense, bootstrap and just focus into the progress. And yeah, as I said, next event. Actually, we have event in Estonia in the April, in the first weekend, or second week of April. So which will be fun. So we will do more fun stuff in Estonia. And we have many events, and believe me, it's many times very interesting to go to other country and to attend in our events, because you will get so many new friends, you will get so much inspiration and motivation. And we keep pushing people from one country to other country, because believe me, every country is kind of different. We have different angles, and you know, we have in Estonia already, maybe Estonia passes that we have people who have Skype and many successful companies, and we may be missing sometimes really hardcore engineers, so it is your option. So just follow us and we do enjoy it, and just, you know, go and visit our other events. So maybe my last question for the day, because some people want to drink, you know, some people want to sleep, some people want to clean, some people want to have sex, you know.
With toys.
Some people want to have sex without toys, you know. Some girls want to have sex. So, would be like, did you enjoy the event?
Yeah!
Thank you! She also enjoyed it, because she was satisfied, eh?
Marsha has something to say as well.
No, finish this. Yeah, yeah.
So anyway, few things. The hardware that you got, you have to give it back.
So, yeah, what do we need? The Raspberry Pi is definitely, so what are the components that they need to give back?
Can you explain this?
Okay, I think the boards you need to get back. For the next hackathon, the next events we're gonna have.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so give back the hardware and something else. Oh yeah, we wanna finish this with something cool. So I want all of you to come in the front. You're all winners, we wanna give you diplomas, we wanna get a nice picture of this event. So 3, 2, 1, up, and everybody in the front.
Yeah, let's make photo. No, we have video.
Okay, closer together, closer together.
Вот, give me a
picture.
You ready for my selfie?
I'm going to go to the next one.
На раз, запускай.
Це був гараж 48.
25-27 березня 2016-го, місто Київ, Жилянська, 75, бізнес-центр Євразія, Microsoft.